you had U.S. senators, presidential candidates giving money. Kid Rock gave like $5,000. So when white people come under fire for stuff like this, their community steps up in a big way. Like, wait a minute, hold on. Even though you're wrong, write the check. But with blacks, we don't do that. So that's the difference. Asians will defend their people when they're wrong or when they're right. And then if they're wrong, they'll talk to them offline like, hey, you're stupid. What the hell are you doing? But publicly, we're going to come out and defend them all the time. But now that just goes to show you where we are on the world stage as blacks.
True.
So that shows you how powerless we are on the world stage. Why can't we flex our muscles like we should?
Hi guys, welcome to Kenganda. My name is Jenny Tamai and this is the Repart Podcast. I'll let my co-hosts introduce themselves.
Hi guys, Outer Brian here, content creator, man from the East. Good to be here.
You're welcome.
It's your boy Master Gabs back in the building. Happy to be here, man. I'm feeling good today.
Okay.
But I can't believe I'm lucky enough to be sitting next to this guy. So O'Shea Duke Jackson, Sacramento, California, African American.
Okay, guys. Watch this clip with us. It's from Ivy Anita. I think that's how they pronounce it.
Yeah, good YouTuber too.
Yeah. Shout out to her.
Where's she from?
I don't know. I think
she sounds very Nigerian.
Yeah, yeah. She does.
She's hilarious. Or East African.
Yeah.
She's hilarious. I like the way she flows. The way she talks. She was very, very amusing.
I think she's Nigerian. Her accent gives off Nigeria.
Yeah. Yes, it does.
Something with some country in West Africa.
Yes, it
Correct
does.
Us in the comment section. You know how you people are in the comment section. Cut
okay.
that out.
Okay. What we got?
Watch this clip with us and react to it with us.
Guys, it would be wise to fasten your seatbelt for this one because this is an exclusive coming directly from the streets of TikTok, an expose that you could not have seen coming. Prepare yourselves.
Y'all remember last week when I was in Africa and I said I have a whole bunch of information that you don't know about because the media is not going to show you or tell you, and how I didn't feel safe talking about this until I was back in the States? Well, we're going to talk about it, so use your context clues because there's a lot of words that I can't use. I'm going to let you know what farmers is, why it's happening, where it's happening, how long it's been happening, what are happening to innocent farmers, and then I'm going to tell you how I found out about it and how I wasn't supposed to know about it. Nobody's supposed to know about it. But I'm Brittany Scoville, okay? I'm gonna find out that you're not. I don't know how, but I always do. So, hashtag farm is something that's going on across Africa, especially South Africa. Zimbabwe is just above South Africa, and we are about 45 to 50 minutes from the border. People are illegally crossing into South Africa and innocent farmers. Now, let me tell you what. Obviously, there's no facts. This is coming from a very trustworthy opinion. And I'm saying opinion because do what you want with this information. You're not going to find it anywhere else.
So she just stated that there are no facts to back up whatever she's saying right now. Then she went on to say all she is about to say is from a trustworthy opinion. It is at this point right here she was supposed to stop making this video. This video is not even supposed to exist. But she went on yapping nonetheless for over 6 minutes spreading propaganda.
Nobody wants you knowing about it, A, because nobody's gonna want to come if they know the risk and danger, and B, it's honestly kind of crazy that this is actually happening. Some of the stories that I was told left a pit in my stomach, and I double checked the locks on my door. I don't know how to say this without sounding, but this is how it was explained to me. I mean, if you talk about race anytime, someone's gonna call you. So this is basically what I got from what I was told. The government is granting people, white African-Americans and black African-Americans, land.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
But the blacks are getting it for dirt cheap or free. And I know everything's two-sided. This is just the information that I've been told.
That's the thing.
So basically, she's blaming, Brittany Scoble's the chick's name, right?
Mm-hmm.
She's blaming African-Americans for, is it killing farmers in South Africa or getting land in South Africa for cheap with these white African-Americans, and they're coming across from Zimbabwe to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this chick was all viral all across TikTok and everything. Yeah,
she did go viral. They actually banned her TikTok account, and then she created another one where she issued an apology, and she was just like, it's like she was calling people insensitive. or something like that in her apology.
She later apologized. Eh?
She apologized like, oh, stop sending me death threats and not what nonsense. My family is not safe, something like that. You are sensitive. Some. Anyway, guys, what do you think about Madame?
What is a white African American versus a black African American? I watched some of this on TikTok because actually I was going to do my own reaction to it, but I didn't know that this was going to be, I didn't check in the group. But so this Brittany Scobel lady was in South Africa. Is that right?
Yeah.
And so what she's trying to indicate is that not only are these white farmers in South Africa being mistreated and the South African government is trying to keep it under wraps, they have these other friends, notably white African-Americans and black African-Americans, who are coming across to Zimbabwe doing this. Now, she did say, these are rumors that I'm hearing that can't be quantified or even qualified.
Yeah, she said that.
So then, you know, and I saw some of the as stupid as it sounds, when I looked at some of the comments on her Instagram, I saw a lot of white South Africans who were agreeing with what she was talking about. Like, oh, this lady is telling the truth or whatever, or white people. I don't know if those are trolls or whatever. But it seems like to me it's a lot of misinformation, because if you don't even know what a, there's no such thing as a white African-American.
Yeah.
And I don't even think African-Americans have anything to do with what's going on there, period. We do have some people that live in South Africa, but very few are in that region as in comparisons to Ghana. Or should I say maybe Kent? We have more of our community in Africa in Ghana, sometimes Senegal, and then we have them in Tanzania. But I don't even think African-Americans are even there in South Africa. There couldn't be no more than 100 families there. So it just seems like, number one, you don't know what and who the African-American people are, and you're misqualifying our group.
Yeah.
And then you're also misidentifying and stereotype this other group because of your own personal bias. And now that people are trying to cancel you, you're trying to act like, you know, it's not your problem. Why are you issuing death threats? But if you're saying that these people are doing these things and they're not, and what you're telling is truth, how do you expect people to respond?
Yeah.
And I don't know. This is just.
Yeah. When you go to her TikTok page, she pushes the whole stereotype. Like, she's like, oh, I'm in Africa and this is what I woke up to. I think she went to a resort in the jungle, and of course the trees and the wild animals, you know, South Africa with the safari thing. And she's saying, oh, this is Africa. You know, like just trying to push that whole agenda. And then when she got back, she's like, oh my God, I have big news. It's like an announcement. It's like, it's only me. It's breaking news. No one is talking about this. This is the news. They're killing our people. Like, that doesn't even make sense. Maybe there has been an incident where a white person has been killed.
Yeah.
And then maybe she ran. They told her that story and then she ran with it. And then decided to make something out of it. And then when you keep seeing her TikToks, you can see like, she even looks racist. No offense to her. Well, offense. She does look racist.
Yeah.
When she goes ahead to say, oh, I had to like double check my doors and lock my doors. What does she think Africans were doing when her people were taking people away? Where they were taking them as slaves?
There you go.
Were they smiling and waving and trying to get picked up?
No.
Of course, they're also hiding and locking that doors. She's just a privileged white girl who went to South Africa. And I don't know. Either she didn't like the country or she thought that she discovered South Africa as an American in South Africa. And then she keeps pushing this whole thing, Africa, Africa, Africa. Guys, Africa is a continent. It is not a country. Like, I don't understand when people do that. But yeah, guys, what do you think?
So maybe for me, what I think, this is just one of those videos that, I don't know, I just wish there was a way we would ignore such people. Because someone just, not like that, she just woke up and started giving us her own view, her own thoughts. And just like that, she went viral on TikTok.
Everywhere.
And everyone was talking about her. Like, so I think that's just an issue we need to tackle. Eh? Making such people very famous for no reason. Anyway, because like she said, she just, she called it what? A trusted source.
Yeah. Facts or something.
So she's not even sure what she's talking about. She's just talking. Yeah, so that is I don't know what's wrong with her. Like you said, she must be obviously racist, and she's from the States, right? Who would have believed that story more, maybe if it was someone from from South Africa? Because someone from the States.
A great point.
Us who are in Africa, we're not hearing. any news.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then she said, this is what she said, people are dying, like, like stuff is real, like the incident is happening. Yeah. Like it's so, yet us, like, you know, if such an incident was really happening, would be first ones know, like, actually it would be over, it would be all over the news.
Yeah,
it would be over everywhere. Because trust me, there's no way whites can die, and this is just
it's a great point.
It would be so everywhere. So I think she just needed to just get her facts right and
and imagine a white person who feels unsafe in a country that has a large population of white people, and for the longest time white people are ruling that country. Just imagine that.
You know, when I was watching this thing, two things came into my mind.
Okay.
As I was listening to her talk.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, I was pissed. I was like, why am I watching this bull? Like, really? I saw how long the video was. I was like, God damn, I gotta sit through this fuckery. This woman is just spouting the most nonsensical stuff in the world.
Right.
The minute that she said, I don't have any facts.
Right.
You just have to disregard anything that comes out of her mouth after that.
Yes.
Immediately switch her off. Close that YouTube video or close that TikTok account. There's nothing legitimate to listen to after she says, I don't have facts. The other thing that came into my mind was, this really feels like another example of how white women can weaponize their lack of feeling safe and make it a thing.
Right.
Because when she was talking about, I was moving with the PH or whatever, and I needed guards upon guards upon guards upon guards. I'm like,
those are probably tour guides.
Where the hell was she that she needed an armed battalion to move with her? Like,
and who is she?
Who is she?
There you go.
To need a whole crew of armed guards to move around with her. I was like, I'm calling BS on that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm calling BS on the notion that, as Brian said, all of these people are getting murdered and there's no news reporting about it. I'm calling BS on that. Then I watched the video further. I just wanted to make sure that I had all of my intelligent thoughts prepared for this because I don't have much to say, but I just needed to make sure that I said it knowing that I watched everything. So then in the middle of, after she says her piece, and I watched several clips of several South Africans, both black and white and colored South Africans, responding to her.
Right.
Letting her know that she's on some bullshit.
Right.
Letting her know that, who are you to talk about us our country in this way?
Yes.
What are you trying to be? Our savior, our advocate?
Right.
Like, just go home and don't come back.
Yes.
And then she was back on her TikTok talking about the death threats, talking about, what do you expect me to do? Not talk about it? I'm like, yo, this is clout chasing at its finest.
Yes.
Not even at its finest, because this ain't fine.
Right.
This is some bullshit.
Yes.
I should go to the clout.
This is clout chasing at the lowest common denominator of clout chasing.
So right.
I don't even want to give this any more airtime than what it deserves. I think she needs to, first of all, be banned from ever entering not only South Africa, any African country.
Yes.
Every African immigration department needs to know that this woman is a liability to your country with the platform that she has and the number of idiots out there in the world that are willing to listen to and believe what she's got to say. No, you don't need this woman talking anything about her firsthand experience in your country. Keep her out. Don't come back to Africa. You're not welcome.
I also feel that if you are maybe not African and you travel to an African country with that stereotype or that whole notion that I'm not going to be safe, or I'm going to find this and that, I feel like you drive the point home when you get there. It's like when I say, oh my God, maybe I fear this certain region because they're thieves. Now everyone I see is a thief because you can't tell me, if I know that there are thieves here, you're a potential thief. Like, I can't just walk around and think you're not a thief. Like, if you go to a certain country and think they are bad people, of course you're going to start, your mind is just going to start interpreting for you and showing you all the bad things or all the bad people.
Right.
Be more careful, be more this. And I don't know.
Yeah. Let me also say this, and I like how the response was from many people in South Africa, and I agree with Gab's suggestion. Like, if you were a black person and you were to go to, let's say, Israel, and you were to say that, what would your repercussions be, even in the United States?
Exactly.
Like, you wouldn't be in trouble in just Israel. You would be in trouble with any place that's sympathetic to Israel.
Exactly.
Look at what Kanye West did, for an example. Kanye West has a contract, or had a contract, with Adidas, which is a German company. Because the two brothers that had it. One is a Puma, one's Adidas, right?
Yep.
Okay. So Adidas is not even an American company. But you see what the Jews did. Like, look, you have this guy. I know he's making you billions of dollars, but it's better you lose the $1 billion right now than for what we got coming towards you if you keep him on. Because your whole company is going to go under. Get rid of the guy now to save face, or else.
Yeah.
Okay. But now the black world, is good that the blacks came out to do this, but now where are the governments, like he said, that would make her life miserable in the world? But oh, Brittany Scoble knows that there is no what? There's no real consequence. Oh. So she will also probably go back to Africa. Maybe not South Africa, but she'll be back somewhere else. Mm-hmm. And somebody will open, answer will open ours. But you would never get away with that in as a black person in a white country. Now, if you're sitting in Australia, you're going to get punished. In England, you're going to get punished. And that just shows you we have so much work to what to do. Getting banned off TikTok is nothing when you can come back. Are being banned off of Instagram. She wasn't banned off of YouTube.
No.
Right. So her life has not changed. And white people will still support somebody like that. Like, who was this kid that, you know, there was a young man that was killed in New York City on a subway. He was choked to death.
Yeah.
This Marine was arrested.
Yeah.
How much money did they raise for this Marine guy? Those who are sympathetic to this guy within the day? Almost $300,000 or $400,000.
Yeah.
You had U.S. senators, presidential candidates giving money. Kid Rock gave like $5,000. So when white people come under fire for stuff like this, their community steps up in a big way. Like, wait a minute, hold on. Even though you're wrong, write the check. But with blacks, we don't do that. So that's the difference. Asians will defend their people when they're wrong or they're right. And then if they're wrong, they'll talk to them offline like, hey, you're stupid. What the hell are you doing? But publicly, we're going to come out and defend them all the time. But now that just goes to show you where we are on the world stage as blacks.
True.
So that shows you how powerless we are on the world stage. Why can't we flex our muscles like we should? Mm. Okay. And in the African Union, we're talking about the Africa Free Trade Agreement. And we see that South Africa just got disrespected. But you want us to trade, but then allow people to come out and not take a stance on when they trash your country. And then she can go and, you know, let's say fly into Mozambique the next day or whatever. It just goes to show you that Africa is not united. The black world's not united, right? Mm. We have to look at that, because that sort of narrative is toxic, not just to South Africans. It's toxic to me. And the reason why I should care about it, because number one, we're all black, but she said who? White African-American. She said who? Black African-American, right? Mm-hmm. We had nothing to do with it, but see, our people were also put in the same boat. And it just goes to show you that even though we're blacks and we differ, we say, oh no, these aren't our people. No, but to her, all of y'all are the same. Because I can't even differentiate. When I see a South African, I see criminality I see in the African-American community. That's who I see. So we have to be mindful of how people look at us as blacks. And when that kind of messaging comes out, we got to be quick to turn that off and say, hey, listen, this chick, we got to get out of the continent. Because what it does is, if you're a person that's dumb and you're watching her video, what if you said you had a trip to Botswana? Now you might not go now, right? Mm. So if you want to go to Senegal, you're gonna connect. Oh, well, Senegal and South Africa are far away. But because it's Africa, we're clumping in together. No, I'm not going to Senegal because that happened. We don't think about that with Europe. Like, if something happens in, let's say, Lithuania, you don't say, well, I'm not going to England because something happened in Europe and Lithuania. You don't say that. Mm. But if something happens in South Africa, you can say, I'm not going to Sierra Leone. Because that's how we clump Africa in a box like that. Mm. So I agree, but it just goes to show you, we need to get that kind of messaging. We need to attack that very quick as a black community, as a Pan-African community, and say, no, this chick has to suffer. She's not only apologized, she's gonna be all platforms, everything. Because if you do it to the Israelites and Jews, the as some people call it, the European Jews, Ashkenazi Jews, they'll punish you. Mm.
That's so true.
Yeah.
That's so true. I just thought it was the dumbest statement of all time. I was appalled and shocked at just how, first of all, the way that she was talking, she just looked and sounded like she didn't know what the hell she was talking about. Mm. She looked like she was freestyling and making this up like story time. She literally looked like she was telling a bold-faced lie and mm-hmm. she was just trying to figure it out as she went
exactly.
along.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I wasn't feeling it.
Yeah. And you know, there are a lot of things. If you really want to talk about South Africa, there are a lot of things that happen there.
Mm.
Actually, the real crime should have addressed. But she decided to pick some issue that wasn't even there.
Mm-hmm.
There's this point that made me laugh. I saw it in one of the comments. Whereby she was, because she said this has been happening for a long time. I think since 2020.
Mm-hmm.
So they were like, someone was like, if they were really killing the white people since 2020, because remember the white people are around, I think, 7 to 8%.
Mm-hmm.
They're like, if they were really killing people from 2020, the white people, by now there would not be any white person.
True.
Because if they've been killing.
Yes.
Yeah, so it just there makes sense.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And the fact that she says something about free land, I don't think there's any country anywhere that's giving out free land.
No.
No.
It's not real, guys.
No.
If anyone ever tells you this country is giving out free land, that's the biggest lie.
No.
They just want to take your money, and then after a few years, they're going to come and take you off that land. Yeah. You're thinking you're getting something free? Mm-hmm. No, there's not free land,
guys. They're
giving
you land, maybe it's just for investment, like the way the governments do.
Yeah.
Not in this Africa, though. Free land in Africa?
Jeez. Uganda actually does give out free land.
Yeah, they do.
For investors.
For business?
Investors, yeah.
Oh, they do. I didn't know that.
It's a whole process.
For large scale development, like industrial development, factories.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Well, that makes sense. Yeah. That's not really free then. Mm. But
no, exactly. It's not free.
Yeah, free means I'm giving it to you and you ain't got to do shit for it. That's free.
No.
Yeah.
So yeah, and she's making it seem like, oh, land is only being given to like black people and then white people are not getting shit. You know what? It's just, like Gab said, she made no sense.
But shout out to the YouTuber who was making the commentary. I was thoroughly entertained by her commentary. Yeah. She's really good. I'm going to subscribe.
She knew how to narrate.
Mm.
Yeah, she's really good. Yeah.
Anything else? That's it?
Nope.
Stop painting.
Don't email me, Oshay Duke, on Instagram.
Gabs, please.
Master Gabs, Allergic to Average Podcast, at @A2A_podcast. YouTube, check me out.
Brian?
Yeah, Outer Brian, OUTA, Brian, everywhere, all social media. You can check out my content.
Okay. And you can follow us at Kenganda Nation. Email us at teamkenganda@gmail.com. Subscribe to our dating show at The Pan-African Dating Show. Follow me at Janita Maya. We'll see you guys next time. Bye.